Yesterday, Georgia's Republican Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger appeared in front of the grand jury that has been convened in Fulton County by District Attorney Fani Willis, who is overseeing the case of Donald Trump possibly interfering in Georgia's election process. Raffensperger, of course, is the central witness in this case because, after all, he's the one who received the phone call from Donald Trump asking him to, quote, go find the votes. So I imagine he had quite a few things to tell the grand jury because, after all, he did mention in a book that he published last year that he felt threatened by the phone call that Donald Trump made to him. So if he's willing to say that in a publicly published book, there's no telling what he told the committee. Now, of course, just so everybody is aware, we don't know what he told that grand jury. And we're probably not going to know until the end of this. It's very unlikely that we're going to have leaks coming out from this grand jury. It's unlikely that Raffensperger is going to go and hold a press conference and say, yes, I told them X, Y, and Z. Not going to happen. So we don't know, which is always a horrible thing to have to tell people. But to be honest, we do not know what Raffensperger said. But the fact that he went, right? He didn't fight it. As far as we have known from this point and going back, Raffensperger has been cooperating with the prosecutors. He has turned over documents. He has turned over other materials. Other people from his office have done the same thing even before meeting with this grand jury, even before the grand jury was impaneled in Fulton County. So Raffensperger has been doing what he is supposed to be doing, so that's always a good thing. And of course, in case you haven't been following along with what is taking place in the state of Georgia, last week Fani Willis announced that she is likely going to be pursuing racketeering charges against Donald Trump and all of his allies in the state. And what that means is they believe there were enough players, which would include, of course, Rudy Giuliani, Donald Trump himself, possibly Lindsey Graham, and a bunch of other people in and out of the state of Georgia, who likely were involved with this scheme. So she last year brought in an expert prosecutor for racketeering cases, and he is one of the 10 prosecutors that she has working on this case. That's a lot of prosecutors and a little bit of an odd specialty to bring in, unless, of course, that is the route that you want to go. That would probably be, even though it's a little harder to prove racketeering cases, if you're able to prove it, that would be the most efficient way to take everybody down that was involved in this. It may also be an easier way to get certain individuals who played a lesser role in it to flip on some of the other people. You know, we cannot charge you with the racketeering. We'll leave you out of that charge if you just tell us who to go after, what happened, give us the documents, be a cooperating witness. We'll hit you with something less, or we may not hit you at all. So that's the beauty of going after it from a racketeering standpoint. Again, harder to prove, but if you can get it, you can get everybody. So that's what's happening in the state of Georgia right now. Raffensperger testified. We're not going to know what he said probably for many, many months now, but the investigation is moving forward full steam ahead, and Fani Willis seems determined to take down Donald Trump. Do you know what the fastest growing crime in America is? For years, this crime's rate has been surging and affecting millions of Americans. I'm talking, of course, about identity theft, and it happens to 1 in 20 Americans. Yet, despite this, those who have had their identity stolen are often shocked when it happens. Imagine trying to log into your email account one day only to see that the password had been changed hours ago. Then you start getting notifications of activity from your bank, credit cards, crypto accounts. That's when the feelings of panic, fear, anxiety, paranoia, disbelief, shock, and anger and frustration and guilt start to set in. That's why I am excited to partner with Aura, who is sponsoring this video. Aura is identity theft protection, fraud monitoring, a VPN, password management, and antivirus software all combined into one easy-to-use app. Aura monitors the dark web for your emails, passwords, and social security numbers and sends alerts fast, right to your phone and email. When it comes to fraud, every second matters. Connect your credit and bank accounts and get notified of any changes up to 4 times faster than Aura's competitors. Their VPN allows you to stay anonymous online by keeping your browsing history and personal information safe and encrypted. And their antivirus software that will block malware and viruses before they infect your devices is absolutely vital. I've been using Aura to protect my personal information, and it couldn't be easier. Setup literally just takes a couple of minutes, and you can link all of your financial accounts for monitoring to protect you. As someone that's had their personal banking information stolen several times in the past, I can't stress enough how important this service is and how great it is to have the peace of mind that Aura brings. So protect yourself and your family from America's fastest growing crime. Try Aura free for 2 weeks and see if any of you and your family's personal information has been compromised. Start your free trial today at aura.com/ROF.